Isleworth murder suspect Bob Ward is asking a judge to keep information seized by the police out of public view.
His attorney says Ward's medical records and business dealings should not be released. West Shore reporter Bob Keeling has been looking into this. And Bob, what about the public's right to know?
Well, Martha, Ward argues that his right to privacy does not go away just because he's accused of murder, and a First Amendment expert we talked to agrees.
When deputies arrested Bob Ward for his wife Diane's murder, through search warrants, they confiscated his cell phone and computers. In this emergency motion for protective order, Ward is asking the judge to prevent any law enforcement agency from releasing information seized by the police.
Relevant information in this case that has been properly seized will most likely be made public.
By getting a judge's permission to serve the warrants in the first place, an attorney who specializes in First Amendment issues says police have already made a successful case that Ward's belongings are proper for them to have and potentially make public the information stored in them.
The public's right to know and the rights to a fair and open trial will generally supersede any confidentiality concerns.
But Walter says Ward does not lose his right to privacy when it comes to confidential medical records or communication with lawyers covered by the attorney-client privilege. And it is perfectly proper for Ward's attorneys to ask a judge to review the material himself behind closed doors before allowing police or prosecutors to make that information public.
And it appears that is what the judge is going to do. He set a December 15th hearing date to consider this motion.